capacitance, which is your second chapter. Already we finished our first chapter, that is electric charges and electric field. In that chapter we discussed what is electric charge, what are properties of charges, force between two charges, force between multiple charges, and what is electric field, what are electric field lines, and Gauss law, and some derivations regarding electric field using Gauss law. All these things we discussed in the previous chapter. And in this chapter, we are going to discuss what is electrostatic potential. Before going to explain electrostatic potential, I am going to explain some previous definitions, that is electric field. Okay, then what is electric field? Electric field is the region around the charge, up to where other charged body can experience force of attraction. Let us consider here is a charge, and this is the region around the charge. Within this region, if any charged body enters, it will experience either force of attraction or force of repulsion, and this region is known as electric field. Similarly, I am going to recall you one more definition, that is gravitational potential energy.
Within electric field, within electric field. Electric field against electric force. Electric force without acceleration. Without acceleration. This is the definition for electrostatic potential. Okay, let us consider here is a charge, that this is plus Q charge. I am going to call it as source charge. And this is the region. This is the region around the charge. This is the region around the charge up to where the electric field is existing. It means this is the electric field of this charge. Now I am going to consider another charge here. Let this is a test charge, which is Q naught. Test charge means it is a charge which is having unit magnitude and which do not affect the electric field of source charge. That's why I am going to consider a test charge. Initially, this test charge is at infinite distance. Now I am going to bring this test charge from infinity to any point within the gravitational field. In order to bring this charge from infinity to any point within the gravitational field, I need to do some work against the electric field. This is the direction of the electric field. I need to do work against the electric field. And this work done is stored in the form of electric potential energy. So, electric potential energy, it is denoted by letter, capital letter V. That's why I can write electric potential energy V is equal to work done. Work done in bringing the unit quantity charge. That's why it's formalized work done divided by charge. So, work done means symbolically we can represent it with W and charge is Q, and this is the expression for electrostatic potential. Then SI unit. Electrostatic potential V is equal to formula W upon Q. W means work done. So work done it is measured in joules. That's why SI unit of electric potential joule. And this is charge SI unit is coulomb. That's why this is joule per coulomb. R one more SI unit. Work done means it is force into displacement. Force is measured in terms of Newton and displacement is in a meter. And for charge, its SI unit is coulomb, Newton meter per coulomb. One more SI unit, that is volt. It is noted by capital letter P. This is the definition of electrostatic potential. So next concept is potential difference. Okay, already we discussed what is electrostatic potential. Now, potential difference. Let us consider here is a source charge. Let this charge is plus Q. I am going to consider this is the direction of electric field. I am going to take two points here. This is point A and this is point B. This is point B and this is point A. From the definition of electrostatic potential, electrostatic potential means it is amount of work done in bringing the unit positive touch charge from infinity to at that point this is the electric field. Let us assume this is the reason for electric field for this source charge. Initially here is a unit positive touch charge. I am going to bring this unit positive touch charge to point A. At point A its electric potential is Va. It means going to bring this charge from infinity to point A, I need to do some work, and that work done is stored in the form of energy, and that energy is called as electrostatic potential.
potential at point A. Now again I am going to bring same charge from infinity to at point B. Again I need to do some work. It means this work done is stored in the form of potential energy here. Electric potential energy at point B I am going to take it as B. Then potential difference means it is potential difference between two points. It means potential difference means what we can define. It is the work done in moving the unit positive charge from one point to another point. That is called as potential difference. Let VA be the potential difference at point A and VB be the potential difference at point B. Therefore potential difference equal to VB minus VA. VB minus VA. From the definition, what we can say, potential difference means it is work done in moving the unit positive charge from one point to another point. This is called as potential difference. That's why simply what we can write WAB. It means it is amount of work done in moving the unit positive charge from point A to point B divided by Q. This is the expression for potential difference. Okay. In this class, we discussed about electrostatic potential and potential difference. In the next class, we are going to derive the expression for electrostatic potential for an isolated point charge. Thank you.